Welcome all to yet another video of Dr. RS and You, Science of Cosmetics and Personal Care Products. Today, we are in part 62. We will be discussing on the major category of skin cleansing. We will be discussing about scrubs. Exfoliating is the process of removing dead skin cells from the surface of the skin using granular substances, a chemical or exfoliation tool. Skin naturally sheds dead skin cells to make room for new cells about every 30 days. This we are repeating again and again. Stratum corneum cells, the outer layer of the stratum the outer layer of the skin, the stratum corneum cells, they are dead cells. The stratum corneum cells, new cells will form, old cells will shed itself, right? The process of the stratum corneum formation is dynamic, it's not static, right? So new cells formed about every 30 days. Sometimes dead cells don't shed completely. Sometimes these dead cells don't shed completely. This can result in dry, flaky patches and clogged pores. Exfoliating can help to prevent this. Right? So scrubs aid in this, removing these dead cells which are not removed. Scrubs work by removing dead skin, leaving behind a layer of younger, healthier skin behind. Regular use of an exfoliant keeps skin smooth and glowing by constantly exposing new skin. Use of an exfoliating scrub can also remove lingering facial makeup which may not have been totally cleaned earlier. So scrubs essentially remove the dead cells, more necessarily the loose dead cells in the outermost part of the skin where it is not removed properly. The exfoliation is not complete, it's not removed properly. So scrubs remove those things and even it out and thus cleans the clogged pores also. That is the function of scrubs. Scrubs, there are few abrasive materials to choose from the manual of exfoliation, including cleansing scrubs. This is what we will be focusing on, right? We will be focusing on cleansing scrubs and pumice stones of crows, right? Then there is an exfoliating glove, dry brushes, loofahs, micro needling and micro dermabrasion rollers, no? Dermabrasion, which removes the outermost dead layer. So handling micro derma rollers and micro needling need a separate expertise and a dermatologist supervision, right? So loofahs are materials where you rub in the body, same way loofahs aid in foaming in body washes and all, it aids in foaming and then have abrasive action also, right? Scrubbing action also. Dry brushes, exfoliating gloves. So we will be seeing more on cleansing scrubs, right? Now scrubs are of different particle size, 75 to 200 micrometers for face, 200 to 70 micrometers for body, 700 to 2000 micrometers per feet. The smallest grain size used for facial application, the larger grain size for body scrubs. Abrasive index depends on hardness and particle size. It ranges from 1 to 5. Right? So, examples of scrubs, cosmetic scrubs, shells and kernels of almond, apricot, argan, olive, peach, walnut, coconut, shea, lychee. Fruits, shells and kernels, then fruits, apple, pomegranate, grape, lemon, orange, cranberry, dried fruits. Then minerals, corindon, garnet, lithothamium, pearl, quartz, rhyolite, volcanic sand, magnetite. Herbs and spices, cocoa, coffee, ginger, guarana, hemp, lotus, bamboo, rice. Then sugar and salt, seeds, blackcurrant seeds, cranberry, raspberry, strawberry, kiwi, pepper, flowers and leaves, rosa, chamomilla, calendula, lemongrass, olive leaves, rosemary. These are examples of some of the scrubs. These are examples of some of the scrubs generally used. Right? So, scrubs, product forms, anhydrous base, surfactant base and emulsion based products. We will see some prototype formulation of all the three. The anhydrous form, methyl glucose dioleate, it's an emulsifier, glycerin, humectant, glyceryl isostearate, emollient, olyl betaine, chembetaine, it's another surfactant. Avogadro oil, emollient. So, this is a non-aqueous base. Non-aqueous base, no water. In this, sea salt is added at 69% as a scrub. Mix part A ingredient, disperse sea salt. So, in this type of formulation, you can use also crystal sugar as a scrub. Sea salt or crystal sugar can be used as a scrub. So, while the base gives an emollient feel to the skin, sea salt and crystal sugar gently exfoliates the skin. So, this is the example of anhydrous body scrub. Surfactant based jojoba wash, right? It contains xanthan gum, glycerin, sodium diethyl glucoside, hydroxypropyl sulfonate, surfactant at 24%, cocoa betaine, aloe, preservative and perfume, citric acid to adjust the pH, hydrogenated jojoba oil beads. This is the scrub. What is scrub? Hydrogenated jojoba oil beads as a scrub at 4.25%. So basically disperse xanthan gum in glycerin to create a slurry. Add the slurry to water with moderate mixing. Mix completely hydrated. Add ingredients 4 to 7 in order. Gentle mixing, mixed until homogeneous. Adjust the pH, add the scrub and disperse the scrub. This is the exfoliating jojoba wash, surfactant based scrub. Then emulsion based face scrub, right? So this contains citryl alcohol and citryl glucoside as emulsifier, citryl alcohol, capric triglyceride emollient, shea butter, apricot kernel oil emollient, dicapital carbonate emollient, antioxidant tocopherol, then glycerin humectant, xanthan gum rheology modifier, preservative. These are all pigments. Sodium hydroxide to adjust the pH to 5 to 6. Silica is used as a scrub at 2% level, and bitter cherry shell powder also used as a scrub at 2% level. Perfume quantity sufficient. So heat phase 1 and 2 to 75 degrees. When phase 2 are homogeneous, add phase 1 to phase 2 with mixing. Homogenize, cool to 60 to 55 degrees and add phase 3, right? Cool to 35, adjust the pH to 5 to 6. At 30 degrees, add the scrubs and perfume, disperse it into the emulsion fully. So, polythene beads were used as scrubs traditionally, but now it caused lot of environmental impact because it's not biodegradable. So now all natural scrubs are used. Pumice stone is a high abrasive, no? Abrasive index is almost 4 to 5. That is used as a scrub for feet. Scrub for feet. So an abrasive index of 2 to 3 will be ideal for face. No? 3 to 4 for body and 4 to 5 for legs and feet. So you can use if it is in a body wash, it can be in a surfactant based, this scrub can be in a surfactant based formula. For the face, it can be an anhydrous formula, right? Sea salt or sugar in an anhydrous emollient base formula. Or for a face, you can have a emulsion based, cream based formula also, right? These are the scrubs. So selection of the scrub materials and formulating the base, what is the purpose? So for body, for feet, for face, for feet, the anhydrous base also works very well. It soothes. At the same time, the abrasives remove the dead stratum corneum cells, and then which are loose, and then it smoothens the feet. So that is how you can selection of the scrubbing material is very essential, and what is the purpose you are going to use it, whether it's going to be for face, body or feet. Based on that, you can select the scrubbing materials, right? So this is what I would like to share with you on the face scrubs. Now, rather scrubs, right? Scrubs. Scrubs can be for face, body and feet. Now, we will see some of the products that are in the market sold as scrubs. Thank you for listening to me in this video. Till we get connected in the next video, thank you for listening to me. Be happy, be safe, be smiling. Bye. Thank you.